let's be serious here. Let's stop pushing lies about what's happening. They know the exploitation is happening. It's happening in Niger. It's happening in Burkina Faso. It's happening in Mali. It's happening in every African country. Let's make no mistake about this. We're sick and tired of giving up our lunch to Western nations. African children, they need to eat too. African children need to go to school. African children need good healthcare systems. Behind all that abuse.
Welcome to the channel where a United Africa is an undisputed Africa. So here in this video we're about to watch is the African Union former ambassador to the United States, Arikana Chikombori. And she's giving her armor and she's doing this interview and they're talking about Niger and the coup and Africa and the revolution that's going on in Africa and the continent right now. And in this video, you're going to see the passion she has for the continent when she pushed back on this narrative that the West is trying to push that the former president of Niger that's being ousted is loved by the world. So let's take a look in this video and then we'll discuss it after.
Boom. Let me ask you, Ambassador, let's take Niger for a moment. President Mohamed Bazoum is a popular president in the West. You know, the IMF liked him, the World Bank liked him, the United States liked him, France seemed to like him. I would like our listeners to understand the gap in the popularity of someone like President Bazoum and performance. And what is going on that makes that revolution, that coup, as we see it, in Niger, a different story than we're seeing?
The performance that you're talking about is the performance of what Nigerian minerals are doing to French education, to French healthcare, to French infrastructure. You tell me, why is it that 95% of Nigerian uranium is powering over 30% of France, while over 70% of Nigerians have no electricity? How is that okay? How is even President Bazoum proud of himself with that fact? There is no development in Niamey. I was in Niamey a few years ago when we had the AU summit. It was pitiful to see the level of underdevelopment that Niger has. There is no development in Niger. Let's make no mistake about it. Niger is the second poorest country in Africa, in the world, in fact. So how can President Bazoum be proud of himself? What development is he talking about? You're talking about developing France? There is no development in Niger, one of the poorest countries on earth. And of course, IMF would love them. World Bank would love them. France would love him because he is allowing the pilferage, the exploitation to continue. And that's why the people are rising up to say, if you can't stand up to the bullies and tell them that the exploitation can no longer continue and look President Macron in the face and say, President Macron, how is it okay that my money, my bank reserves, my natural resources are funding French education, are funding French healthcare, are funding French infrastructure? How is that okay, President Macron? Answer us. Africans in Niger, they want to know. So when you tell me that he is favored by the West, it makes sense. But he's definitely not favored by the people because there is no development. Let's be serious here. Let's stop pushing lies about what's happening. They know the exploitation is happening. It's happening in Niger. It's happening in Burkina Faso. It's happening in Mali. It's happening in every African country. Let's make no mistake about this. We're sick and tired of giving up our lunch to Western nations. African children, they need to eat too. African children need to go to school. African children need good healthcare systems. Behind all that abuse, we need to let the Western world know that there are millions of African children who are going hungry, millions of African children who are dying, millions of women, African women who are dying, giving birth to another life, millions of African youth who are unemployed, all because the Western world is continuing with the agenda of exploitation, exploitation, and exploitation of the African continent. That era is over. Well, and we're coming together as Africans and saying, enough is enough. This has got to stop.
So guys, here you see, hear that passion and that proudness that the ambassador have, Miss Arikana Chikombori. And you see how the interviewer trying to paint the president of Niger, ousted president, as the IMF loves him, the World Bank loves him, France loves him, the West loves him. And that is the number one mark of a puppet. Whenever I see a president in Africa is loved by the World Bank, African Union, and loved by everyone, no fair fuck, he's doing nothing for his country. And hence the reason for the coup. So this is what he's explaining to him. And you see, the parasitic relationship the African Niger had with France, and not only Niger, most of the former colonies of France. Oh, it's kind of a little bit hard, really. Most of the former colonies of France, like Burkina Faso, Guinea, Chad, and all these other countries, Congo, and Kaban, and all these other countries, where you have multiple coups going on in the country. But wait, you notice the forcefulness Icarus is trying to attack Niger with the help of France and America, but yet Kaban have a coup recently, and not one Western country said anything about the coup in Kaban. Why? Because Kaban don't have nothing of value that they want. There's no uranium there. They have like oil and some a little bit of oil, and that's basically what they have. Oil. They don't have much resources like gold, diamonds, uranium, and Kaban, and anything like that. So there's no one is saying batting an eye. No one is batting an eye and saying the coup in Kaban is wrong. They should put back the president. Not a soul is saying nothing. But yet they are pressuring Niger. Why? Because France is paying 80 cents euro per kilo for uranium in Niger, while they sell it back for 200 euro per kilo. So you see the amount of money France is making after the uranium in Niger. Not only that, they're taking 95% of the oil. Sorry, 95% of the uranium from Niger, and it's running 35% of the electricity in France. And plus the money is also going towards healthcare from the uranium, the same money that they make, the 99% of the money that they're not paying to Niger, and they're packing it in, is going to them healthcare system. Sorry about that. The education system, while Niger, 70% of Niger don't have electricity. And it's also, the country is highly, highly underdeveloped, as the ambassador said. And the education system, they don't have schools because what? The money that this president was giving away freely, willingly. That's why he's so loved by the West and by France and by the World Bank, because what? They have this parasitic relationship, so which they are sucking the lifeblood out of Niger while the citizens basically fend for themselves. So now you can see the reason why this is not a, I would say it as a revolution that's happening on the continent, where they are now stopping the stealing of the oil resources, the parasitic relationship that they have with the African continent. You're now seeing that it's now putting to a stop, because all these puppets of the West, and of especially France in this specific moment, they are now being realized and the people are saying that all because of, I'm gonna say this, because of YouTube. Is done a lot in this era, because now more people have more information about the continent, more people can actually see things happening in real time. And any president that the West hates, know that those presidents are doing good in the country. Know this fair fact. If they dislike a president, he's doing good. The ones that they call dictators, the one they call what they call him again? Like President of Rwanda, they don't like him. President Kagame, they don't like the president of Zimbabwe, Mugabe. They don't like Namibia, Zambia. And most of these presidents they don't like. So these are the reasons why, because they cannot get to use these presidents anymore. I'm not only blaming the colonizers, majority of Africa, but they have invisible hands on the continent, with their in the back. But you have to blame some of these presidents because they're greedy. and they're making millions of dollars off the backs of African brothers and sisters. Like in Kaban recently, the president that was overthrown in Kaban, the coup, this man have 28 properties in France, and he has his son, they found his son with billions of dollars stored in his house. I'm talking about physical cash. Physical cash, billions he have in his house stored. Like he it's like an ornament for him at this point. And this is what is causing the revolution and the coups. So they're using coup as a bad word, but I'm using it as it's a revolution going on the continent. So anyway, let me know what you think about this in the comment section. What the ambassador, the former ambassador of Arikana Chikombori, if you like what she said. And now we now see how the West view these presidents that's being put out of power, and we see how our African brothers and sisters view these said presidents, and what and why they are so backing and 100% with these new leaders taking over these countries. So it's seven. So let's recap. You have Burkina Faso, Mali, Guinea, Chad, Gabon, now Niger. I'm missing one. Anyway, I'll get back to that. Anyway, let me know what you think about this in the comment section, and then I'll reply to your comments, and then we can have a discussion about it. Don't know. Thanks for watching. Boom.